Welcome to the AFR Saints channel, where we provide you daily content on your favorite team, the New Orleans Saints. Do us a favor and hit that subscribe button. Be sure to leave your comments below and smash that like button. Who dat? The kind of significant news today as a Saints begin OTAs is not so much what's going to happen on the field or Dennis Allen's OTAs, all that sort of stuff, but more so who is there. And I'm not even talking about the rookies that are there or Jameis Winston as a veteran player there at OTAs. The thing that's the most important to remember about OTAs is they are voluntary. They are voluntary organized team activities there at this point of the year. So you don't have to attend. But OTAs are here. And one thing that we do know, and Nick Underhill tweeted this on Monday evening, is Michael Thomas is in the building. So while that may not seem super significant, keep in mind where this whole thing has transpired over the last year and a half. Certainly, it's been very contentious over the last year, but really over the last year and a half, as we've monitored from Thomas's ankle injury at the end of the 2021 season and how it all transpired last offseason and through all of this year, the fact that Michael Thomas is there for voluntary team activities is massively significant, because there was so much conversation and contentious argument about whether or not Michael Thomas would ever return, would he be part of this organization, all of that good stuff. And we seem to have our answer now. Not that we doubted it. The question is, can he be ready, healthy to go for week one? But as we kind of look back at the Michael Thomas saga, it seems like it's nearing its end. Like, let's kind of jump in a little bit of a time machine and remind ourselves here. This is how it sounded on draft night in 2016.
With the 47th pick in the 2016 NFL draft, the New Orleans Saints select Michael Thomas, wide receiver, Ohio State.
Deuce McAllister did the honors that night, announcing the selection of Michael Thomas, 47th overall. His college coach, Urban Meyer, was actually on the set for the NFL Network's draft coverage. And little did we know at the time, but he gave us a preamble of what we could expect just seconds after Mike Thomas was drafted.
His greatest strengths are ball skills, and he's a competitive SOB now. In practice, he gets in a fight about twice a week.
Remember when Michael Thomas and Chauncey Garner-Johnson got in a fight at practice? That was foreshadowing there by Herb, but boy, oh boy, were we treated to what Mike Thomas had early in his career. 1,100 yards as a rookie, 1,200 yards back in 2017, 1,400 yards in 2018, an NFL record, 149 receptions for 1,725 yards in his fourth year in the league, and this is how the record breaker sounded.
Reeves looking his way, and there it is, a new NFL record, reaching across for a touchdown.
How about it? How about it? Congratulations to Michael Thomas, and what a way to do it.
144 receptions on the season, a new National Football League record.
Well, he tack on five more in that game, and 2019 begot 2020 and grander aspirations, but injury would come in the middle of the 2020 football season, and that led Sean Payton to be kind of contentious.
Sean, has Michael Thomas been ruled out for Monday's game?
No, we'll let you know.
Is there any possibility he ends up on IR with the new IR rules?
I'm going to say this one more time this season, and then I'm just going to ignore injury questions because it's easy to do over a phone call. All right? I'm not going to discuss injuries. Maybe they did in Cincinnati, but we don't do that here.
Sean.
Doing my job, Sean.
I am too.
Bad form, Sean, but he was testy. His star receiver was injured. Battled back. Thomas would finish the season on the bum ankle. And then the offseason came when Thomas was going to get it all taken care of. And then last summer, Ian Rapoport gave us the bad news.
Original plan was for him to have a little bit of a cleanup early on in the offseason and then have him be fine. What we know now is, as sources have explained, Thomas had surgery to repair torn ligaments in his ankle in June. The recommended recovery time, recommended rehab time, was about 4 months. So if you go forward from early June, that basically takes you up to November. So conceivable that Michael Thomas misses about half of the season.
Well, Michael Thomas had surgery because he didn't tell nobody. Ghosted the Saints, and boy, did that piss off Sean Payton.
Well, look, it appears we're going to have to spend some time without him. It's disappointing, and we'll work through it with the other players that are here. But the surgery took place, and obviously, we would have liked that to have happened earlier than later. And quite honestly, it should have.
Oh, Sean Payton calling out Michael Thomas, and Mickey Loomis did the exact same thing.
He came back. He played in the last two preseason game or last two postseason games. Excuse me. Still had a few issues after the season. Look, it was decided that he was going to treat that conservatively, and I think we all had an expectation that that would heal and he'd be fine coming into camp this year. But we get to the mini camp, and obviously it wasn't quite right. So we had to make the call and collectively made the call to have the surgery in June. Look, obviously, if we would have preferred that surgery to be earlier in February or March, but it wasn't. Hopefully he's had a good result so far, and hopefully we'll get him back sooner rather than later.
Sean Payton and Mickey Loomis called out Michael Thomas. Thomas went to Twitter. They tried to damage your reputation. You saved theirs by not telling your side of the story. So Michael Thomas went to social media to tell his side of the story. And after that, it seemed as though things quieted down a little bit. Of course, Michael Thomas was then ruled out for the entirety of the 2021 season. And there appeared to be healing. Listen to Mickey Loomis last year.
Well, look, obviously, when he had that surgery, that was determined in June, and so we've known since then that the conservative treatment didn't work, and that we had to do surgery. So we've had a little time.
They had time to prepare for it, and Sean Payton started defending his player as the season went along as well.
I think it's accurate to say that there was a setback, and it wasn't anything of his. He's working his tail off, and the setback had more to do with the procedure he had initially that was just done in. As they went through the scans, there's a chance that he may have to have another procedure done. And so I can't call in and have Dr. Anderson get on the call with us and explain to you, but Michael is working his tail off to get healthy and become available. And I think that this isn't anything he can control.
Sean Payton defends his player. They go through the season the way that they did. Michael Thomas continues to rehab, which brings us to today. Angelic, saintly, even, where Michael Thomas is at voluntary OTAs, nearing health. His new coach, Dennis Allen, says their aim is to have him ready to go for week one. Doesn't matter a lick if Michael Thomas is running around on the field at all at OTAs. It's just about getting ready for a three-headed monster of Michael Thomas, Jarvis Landry, and Chris Olave. Thomas, the 2019 Offensive Player of the Year. Jarvis Landry, who had the most receptions in the first five seasons of any receiver in the history of NFL. Of the NFL at the time, he was through his first 5 years, breaking Larry Fitzgerald's record. And then, of course, came Chris Olave, taken in the first round of this year's draft. The best receiving core the Saints have ever assembled in franchise history. Ready to get the Saints back into a postseason push, and starts right now with Michael Thomas there for voluntary workouts at OTA. Hey, thanks so much for watching. Please leave your comments. I love to interact, and be sure to hit the red subscribe button below.